Hey everybody, it's me, Ned. I just went running. I think I just ran like 5 miles, something like that. It's about, I don't know, 20 degrees out, something like that. But you know what I love to drink after going for a run when it's super, super cold out in the winter? Ribola Riboli. This is really cool. This is from Ribola in Frascati outside of Rome. This is 2016. It is... I don't remember what the hell they grow up here. God damn it. It's in Frascati. This is Trebbiano. I know they're growing Trebbiano, Malvasia, Bombino Bianco. Yes. Various versions of Trebbiano. Anyway... So, woo, it's fizzy. I don't know where that went. Fizzy wine from Ribola. This is, it doesn't even say their names on here, does it? Man, maybe doing this right after running. Wow, that's really delicious. It tastes like grapefruit, but without the citrus, like without the citrus edge to it. Ooh, and kind of pineapple-y. It's like a dry, pineapple-y, like hint of grapefruit, but kind of round. Like it's not citrusy, and of course it's not sweet at all. Oh boy, it's like really fantastic grown-up orange Gina. Boy, why can I not remember their names? Jeez, I can picture them. I visited the winery in the spring. It's this amazing little tiny, like, 5-acre valley in Frascati outside of Rome. Like, I don't know, half an hour outside of Rome that belonged to the patriarch of one of the giant industrial Frascati houses, but he had kept it as, like, his own private personal little garden vineyard that he farmed the way that, you know, he had farmed like growing up as a kid. So all these interesting old indigenous versions of like Trebbiano and Malvasia and Cesenese, stuff like that. And he'd planted all kinds of other flowering, like fruit-bearing plants throughout the vineyard, like cherry trees, almonds, apples, pears. There was an apricot tree. There's olive trees all over the place around the sides of it. And different cherries, like different types of cherries and apples and stuff. So the trees would flower at all different times. And thereby, like, they'd bring insects and stuff through the vineyard all, like, throughout the season. And he had, like, so he had worked it really naturally. So when Ribola, I cannot remember their name. When they bought the vineyard, you know, it was like this amazing little like garden outside of Rome, this like super peaceful little spot. And, they just built their winery there. It was over the course of this year. I think it's just up and running now. Obviously, this is a pet nat, finished in the bottle, live yeast in it. Looks pretty amazing here. Fizzy, you know, frothy. There's a flavor in it, too, that reminds me of, like, rosemary. Of the, like, aromatic, peppery spice of rosemary. This is, I mean, like everything they make, this is really, really gorgeous. This is something that just came in. It's the 2016 vintage. I've got like four cases of it. I'm just going to show it around for Christmas, New Year's. This is a super, super amazing, festive, like fun party wine. Or cold weather, winter running wine. So anyway, hope you enjoyed this. It's lovely. It's not that expensive. It's under $20. It's like, I don't know, $18, something like that. So check it out. That's fantastic. Like zero sulfur, really, really delicious living wine. Thanks a lot. Have a good night.